What's up, TGN FPS? It's Jay, Morning After Kill, and today I got some Modern Warfare 3 with you. And this is the kill confirmed game type. It's a type of game type where it's like TDM, but instead of getting the points for the kills, you have to go out and actually run over their body to pick up the dog tags to get the points, and it kind of cuts down on the camping. And on the mic with me today, I have Mr. DJ Arcus. And
Hello.
yeah, hello, Arcus. For those of you that don't know, on TGN FPS, DJ Arcus is the developer behind the Xbox Live indie game Fortress Craft.
I did Burnout as well. I like for talking about Burnout as a rule.
Oh, you did Burnout as well.
Yeah, did you not know that? I did loads of games. I've done like 60 games on the Xbox and PlayStation and stuff.
As a developer, I wanted to get your opinion. What do you what's your take on, what these games are doing today with the, if it's not broke, don't fix it type approach?
Unfortunately, I mean that's with a game like Modern Warfare, Battlefield. I mean the budgets on these games are enormous. I mean really, really enormous. They spend hundreds of millions of dollars making these games, and they have to sell. And they don't like taking risks. A good example is Mirror's. Do you remember you played Mirror's Edge?
Yes, I have.
Good game, very good game. Didn't sell very well, but it was a bit of an experiment. So EA said to DICE, "Hey, go away and do that," and they did it. It wasn't. It was a good game. It wasn't a massive success, but it's good to see that they actually did let them. And then, of course, back to Battlefield 3. I mean, companies like Activision have so few games on their books. I mean, Activision are basically Modern Warfare, Warcraft, StarCraft. That's it. They don't release anything else. They handle their hero franchises. And unless they picked up new franchises I'm not aware of, that's pretty much the only major games. There might be the occasional Spider-Man game. So this game has to sell. If this game doesn't sell, Activision are likely to go bust. So it's probably a bit late now, but if you want to take Activision down, not buying Modern Warfare 3 is probably your best bet.
That actually reminds me of a game that came out a while back. I don't know if a lot of people are going to remember it, but it was called Beyond Good and Evil.
Yeah, that's another flop, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was a great game. The artistic style of the game, the whole premise of the game, where you were armed with nothing but a camera, and I mean, it was a really great game at the time, and it got a lot of attention from the critics, but it didn't sell at all.
Well, I mean, that's the problem with a lot of good games is they don't sell. A lot of this is down to marketing. We had issues where the marketing department at EA would see our game and saying, "Ah, we like this build that we've seen, so we're going to up your projected sales by 500,000, and because your projected sales are now higher, we'll spend even more money on advertising." And it's like, well, so that doesn't make sense. And a similar thing happens in the publishing industry. So there's a very good book by Stephen King that goes over this, and he says that basically big authors will always sell enough books to make the money back, and the reason for that is because of the advertising. So, but some of the smaller books that are probably better than the John Grisham or the Dan Brown books, they don't sell because the money is not there for marketing. I mean, I don't know. I went on YouTube last night, and the top thing on YouTube, above all of YouTube, at the very top, was watch the Modern Warfare 3 launch party live with special appearances by Chase and Status. And I was very tempted just to tweet there, "I see EA are spending the development budget well."
Oh, you're talking about the difference between Battlefield 3 and Modern Warfare advertising.
To be honest, with the whole, it amazes me that I mean, I'm not gonna get into the COD versus Battlefield thing. As far as I'm concerned, to a great degree, they're basically the same game. They have a lot of similarities, and I know they have a lot of differences, but let's not get into that. So if you were to take both games side by side, 95% of the games are the same. That's not a bad thing. But why the hell do they come out like a week apart? You'd think they'd be better off going, "Hey, let's release this one in 6 months' time and sort of stack them." But it's the same thing happened with Split Second and Blur. Again, very, very similar game types, and they came out on the same day, for heaven's sake. And then both of them just, commercial disaster.
That's actually really interesting that you say that, because a lot of my friends and I, we were talking about that we're wondering, you know, because a lot of my friends, they're like, you know, oh, once Skyrim comes out, you know, I'm not going to touch Modern Warfare 3 or Battlefield 3, and it just seems like there's so many great games that are coming out, and they're coming out in such a short period of time that, you know, a lot of people don't have the time to split between the games.
Yeah, well, this is the this is like the best time for games now. It's right around Thanksgiving is the biggest push for games. So all the games are out for Thanksgiving, and that also means they're out in plenty of time for Christmas. And this is when all it's traditional. All the games come out February, March, April, dead. So, to be honest, I don't quite know why publishers do this. But I worked on a skateboard game. And I'm not making this up. This isn't a joke, okay? One of the marketing people at EA's suggestion was to come out 2 weeks before Tony Hawk's on the basis that they'd be doing lots of advertising and people would buy our game by mistake because it was out first.
Wow.
And we're like, he's joking. And, but no, he was absolutely serious. I have to say, so I'm watching the video here. Can you not shoot the barrels and make them explode?
Some of them you can, the red ones.
What sort of shit game can you not blow up all the barrels? Man, I was going to get it, but not now, I tell you. If I can't shoot barrels at a game, I just don't want to go near it. Blue barrels, shoot the barrels.
Well, that's the difference. That's something that would be more along the lines of more of the old school first-person shooters. You see a barrel, you shoot it, and it explodes, right?
Oh, hell yes, absolutely. No monster was safe in Doom if it was near a barrel, I tell you.
Speaking of old school first person shooters, you know, you've cut your teeth on some of the older ones. What have you played?
All of them, I think. Blimey. To be honest, I mean, the first person shooter I got into was MIDI Maze, say, which was a 1987 Atari ST game, 16 player networking. It was very cool. But yeah, I played a lot of Doom. I had a good computer at the time. Yeah, I played them all. To be honest, I say I think my heart is most fondly in Borderlands. Further back, it would definitely be Doom. Spent so much time in Doom. Used to mod Doom, put my own maps in Doom, all that sort of stuff.
That's pretty much where it all started. But you know, we ran out of time here. That was Kill confirmed on Modern Warfare 3, and you know, Mr. DJ Arcus giving his opinion on how a little bit of insight on how the industry works. So I want to thank you, Arcus, for coming on and giving us a little bit of sneak peek behind the scene there.
Yeah, you're very welcome.
All right, and to everybody out there, thanks for watching, and keep tuned. We got some more good stuff coming.